I hope everybody can see the screen. Okay, I hope everybody can see the screen. And was this problem discussed yesterday in the last class? Tell me, Dilshad, can you see the screen?
Sir, screen is not visible.
Not visible?
Yes, sir.
1 minute. Share nahi ho. अभी देखो तो
हाँ सर
ठीक है.
यस सर
वाज दिस प्रॉब्लम डिस्कस इन द लास्ट क्लास सॉल्व दिस दिस वाज डिस्कस ना
यस सर
एक्चुअली वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सम स्पेशल रूल ऑफ टेकिंग कॉमन एंड मल्टीप्लाइंग विद स्केलर फॉर डिटरमिनेंट्स. ओके द रूल फॉर मैट्रिक्स वी ऑल नो. If we multiply the matrix with some scalar, each and every cell element will be multiplied. But for determinant, there's a special rule. This is not a new rule. The rule is basically same with the old one. Okay, basic thing will be same. But for determinant, we can take scalar common from one single row. Okay, as we have solved in the last problem, this problem. Okay, so in this problem. We divide the first row with factorial n. We divide the first row with factorial n and adjust this thing by multiplying the determinant by factorial n outside. Okay, so I multiply this with factorial n and divide with factorial n. So result for first row will be 1 n + 1 n + 2. I hope everybody is conversant with factorial notation. Similarly. Similarly, for the second row, I am dividing with n plus 1 factorial. I am adjusting here. I am getting 1 n plus 2 and n plus 3 into n plus 2 in the second row. This way, I am getting a new determinant like this. In the outside, factorial n plus 1, factorial n plus 2. And the determinant is now having one column with only one value. So this is actually beneficial. We can multiply, we can subtract any row from other row. We have first subtracted the second row from third row and from first row from second row. Then we have got on 0, 0 in the first column. So that will make the determinant expansion very easy and I got the result. Okay. So this type of multiplying row and column with a scalar and adjusting this with outside, this is the special rule for determinant. Okay. I hope this is clear to all. Now the same rule has been applied in the second problem also. Here, solve this problem. What I have done, I have first divided this thing with a square. Okay. This first column. Okay. First column divided with a square. So what will happen? The first element will be a plus lambda by a. Second element, column wise. Second element b, third element c. So as I have divided it, so I will adjust it here with A. This A will be adjusted, okay? The first column is A plus lambda by A, A, A. Similarly, for the second column, I'm dividing with B. So it will be A, B plus lambda by B and C. And I'm adjusting here with C. Similarly, for third column with C. So now I get one ABC. Now, from this first column, I'm adding A square plus lambda by A and A. So I'm multiplying again with A. I'm multiplying the first column with again A. So what I'm getting, A square plus lambda, A square and A square. And that multiplying one by, well, multiplying A will be adjusted here by dividing A. Similarly, in the second column, I'm multiplying with B, adjusting here with dividing B. And for the third column with C, so that will actually make this ABC one, and the determinant will become this way. This is just rearranging the determinant using the property, okay? So what is the benefit? The benefit is that you get the first row, first column, same, lambda plus S square plus B square plus C square. If I add second and third column to first column, second and third column to first column. And then we are taking this again common, column-wise column, lambda plus S square plus B square plus C square. Then I will get this thing again, subtracting from row to column, I'm getting this. So the value of the determinant will be lambda square into lambda plus S square plus B square plus C square. That will give you the roots 0, 0 and minus of S square, B square, C square. It is not that if I expand the determinant as it is given this way, and if I simplify, the same result will come. It is not that this result will be changed. Don't think that way. Okay, just multiply with scalar or dividing with scalar with adjustment, that is not changing the value of the determinant, never. So if I expand this determinant, I will get the same result with some simplification. But now if I can arrange the determinant in this way, it will be very easy for me. Okay, this is for an easy comfort in convenience in calculation, computation, okay? It's very easy for me. Obviously, one root is minus S square, B square, C square. Another roots are this, lambda square. Okay, that is 0, 0. So this thing is very important to canonically rearrange the determinant so that the expansions become very easy. And now we also have discussed the Cramer's rule and when the solution will exist, when the solution will be infinite, and when there will be no solution. All these conditions will basically exist. If you have forgot, I would like to remember you again the same thing. These are the conditions. Lambda, this delta. Delta is equal to the coefficient matrix. Okay, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, A3, B3, C3 for a 3 by 3 system. For a 3 by 3 system, this is the coefficient matrix. For a 2 by 2 system, this will be A1, B1, A2, B2. Same thing. Okay. Then if this delta not equal to 0, system will have unique solution. Okay. And if delta equal to 0 and along with all this del x, del y, del z are 0, the system will have infinite solution. And if at least one of these del x, del y, del not equal to 0, system will have no solution. Provided there are three variables, okay? Three equations, three variables. Three equations, three variables. For this is the case. And this can be followed in four variable or two variable accordingly, okay? So keeping this in mind, now let us solve some problem on system of equations, which are interesting. Everybody can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is written there? For what value of lambda, the equations 2x plus 3y equal to 8, 7x minus 5y plus 3 equal to 0, and 4x minus 6y plus lambda is equal to 0 are consistent. So it is clearly an inhomogeneous system. Inhomogeneous system, 2x plus 3y is equal to minus 8, or you can say this way minus 8, and 7x minus 5y plus 3 equal to 0, 4x minus 6y plus lambda is equal to 0. Okay. Now, please note that actually the number of variables is what? What is the number of variable? Tell me. What is the number of variable, Priya?
Yes, sir.
What is the number of variable in this system? number of variables. One.
Lambda.
Lambda is not the variable. Lambda is the unknown parameter. What are the variables?
X, Y.
X and Y. For which you will solve the equation. For which you will solve the equation. You are doing this from 19. So, two X and Y are the variables. Now, but this we have given three equations and two variables. Now, if the three equations, this determinant, 2, 3, minus 8, 7, minus 5, 3, and 4, minus 6, lambda, this determinant is not equal to 0. What that will mean? What that will mean? That will mean the rank of the system is 3. Rank of the system is 3 means all the equations are independent to each other. That means what I was saying today in last class, no equation we can construct as a linear combination of others. That means by multiplying with any scalar and then adding or subtracting suitably, we cannot find any one equation from other two. Now, when this will be true? When their determinant is not equal to 0. In that case, the rank is system is 3. But actually, there are two variables. There are two variables only. So the system will become inconsistent in that case. So in order to become consistent, the rank of the system must be less than 3. The rank of the system must be less than 3. So it should be 2. Because we are given only two variables. So equation should be 2. So the system of equation will be consistent if this determinant is equal to 0. Actually, what is happening? When the determinant is actually equal to 0, tell me. When a determinant can be equal to 0, when any row or any column, row and column is same thing by transpose, any row or any column can be converted to 0, 0, 0, isn't it? Tell me. When the determinant will be 0, by hook or crook, we should be able to bring all the 0 in any one row completely or any one column. So this system will be consistent if any one of the row is totally 0. And when any row of the total row is 0, determinant should be, the value of determinant should be 0. That means determinant equal to 0, this amounts to saying that, this actually equivalent to saying that the rank of the determinant is less than 3. Are you getting? So the rank of the determinant will be 2. Now we are getting the determinant equal to 0. That will give you the condition. By just expanding the thing, we get minus 31 lambda plus 248 is equal to 0. So lambda is equal to 8. Lambda is equal to 8. Okay. So if we have lambda is equal to 8, the determinant will be 0. That means the rank of the system will be 2. And we have two equations. Now the system will be consistent. Two equations with two unknown. Basically, the independent system will be 2. What are you getting? The independent number of system will be 2 if the determinant is 0. And if the determinant is not 0, then it will be that its system of equation, independent equation is 3. Are you getting? So lambda is equal to 8 will make the determinant 0. That means the system of equation equal to 2. And number of variables equal to 2. That means the system will be consistent. Now, if you take lambda is equal to 8, then your system will become any two equation you can solve. We have solved 2x plus 3y minus 8 equal to 0 and 7x minus 5y plus 3 equal to 0. Again, by Cramer's rule, it is a 2x2 system. So x is equal to del x by del. What is del? Del equal to 2, 3, 7, minus 5. This one, 2, 3, 7, minus. This is del. And this will be del x. That is replacing this x column with minus 8, 3. Okay. So it will be minus 8, 3 x column or y column, whatever it is, the same thing. So I am getting the values of the x is equal to this, y is equal to this. Okay. They have x column is replaced to 2, 7. This column is replaced by 8, 3, Now they have taken one interchange of column to avoid this minus sign. Okay, just taken interchange of column, avoid this minus sign. 3 minus 5 is taken here, and minus 8, 3 is taken here. Okay, basically, if you write this way, 2x plus 3y is equal to 8, and 3x minus 5y equal to minus 3, this will be 8 minus 3. Basically, this will be 8 minus 3. And if you change one, interchange the column, it will be minus 8, 3. But it is better to write 8 minus 3. Okay, thus you should better write 8 minus 3 and 3 minus 5 this way. You should write 3 your 9-10 book. This way it is given. Okay, so x will be equal to this thing. Just you remember that you write the equation in this way: 2x plus 3y is equal to some inhomogeneous part d1, 7x minus 5y equal to this, and you replace this column of x with the inhomogeneous part, that is 8 and minus 3. That will give you the result. Similarly for y. So solving, we get x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. That means for lambda is equal to 8, the system is consistent and the system will have a unique value. X equal to 1, y is equal to 2. Actually, z is free. For any z, the system will be solved, can be solved. Okay, z is free. Any confusion on this? Can ask any question on this?
सर अगर स्टार्टिंग में ही 3 इक्वेशन का अगर हम लोग सर x पाई वो कर दे तो नहीं होगा सर? वैल्यूज ऑफ x एंड y विल फाइंड सर, इफ यू विल राइट x सर विल फाइंड विल टेक द 2 इक्वेशन सर, 2x प्लस 3y,
हां
द 3 इक्वेशन, तीनों इक्वेशन, हां
वही तो
सर, उसके बाद अगर
ये इक्वेशन कंसिस्टेंट है कैसे पता चलोगे कंसिस्टेंट है कि नहीं, ये कैसे पता चलोगा? बात यह है कि मान लो कि तुम्हारा तो दोनों इक्वेशन दिया हुआ है, 2x plus, try to understand, 2x plus 3y equal to 8, 7x minus 5y, what is that? 5y equal to minus 3. Suppose this is given. So you can solve it. You will have some solution. Okay. Now whether this solution will satisfy the third equation. If the solution is not satisfying the third equation, then your equation will be inconsistent.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we are investigating that situation where the when that will happen, when the third equation will be also an independent equation. But third equation will be independent only when this determinant is not equal to 0. And if the determinant is 0, then actually the determinant is 0 means any one row is 0, 0, 0. That means basically the rank of the system is 2. And basically, there are 2 independent equations. By making determinant 0, we actually ensure the number of independent equations are 2. And that will happen only when lambda is equal to 8. Because after expansion, we are getting determinant value is equal to minus 31 plus 248. So that will give you lambda is equal to 8, for which the determinant will be equal to, otherwise the determinant will not be equal to 0. That means when lambda is not equal to 8, the third equation for a 4x minus 6y plus minus lambda equal to minus lambda, this will be another independent equation. This will be another independent equation that cannot be constructed with the linear combination of the other two. In that case, the system equation, obviously, if you solve this first two, you will be getting 1 and 2 solutions. That solution will not satisfy the third equation. This is the situation. In order to get rid of this third equation independency, we choose the lambda suitably so that the determinant of the entire system is 0. That is actually the dependency, degree of dependency is 2. That means number of independent equations is 2. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And when you know the equation is 2 equations independent only, so you have 2 equations, first 2 equations you solve, then you are getting. So this is the solution, and this solution will be consistent only when you should remember the entire thing at once. This is the solution, x equal to 1, y equal to 2, and this equation will be a consistent solution for the entire system only when lambda is equal to 8. Otherwise, if lambda is equal to not 8, this equation will satisfy only the first two and not the third one. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you put lambda is equal to just x equal to 1, y is equal to 2, in the third equation, what you are getting? 4 into 1, 4, minus 6 into 2, 12. So, minus 8, then plus 8. So, 0. Okay. So, third equation will be automatically satisfied. Minus 8 plus 8 is equal to 0. Otherwise, if lambda is not 8, then it will not be 0. The equation will not be satisfied.
Yes, sir.
So if we forward the Cramer's rule, can we just solve this question by substitution method to get
the answer? I am following the Cramer's rule. See, I am solving the Cramer's rule, but what is the condition for consistency? Consistency condition is this thing. I am following from this thing.
Okay, sir.
Okay. This is another important, actually, safe solution. You all of you know how to solve with Cramer's rule. So this is not to be discussed here, okay? All of you know, I know how to solve equations with Cramer's rule, isn't it? Tell me, any one of you is there who doesn't know how to solve equation with Cramer's rule, simple Cramer's rule equations? All of you know, isn't it? But
yes, sir.
What you don't know is what are the different situations where Cramer's rule should be applied carefully, okay? What are the cases of non-consistency, consistency, infinite solution? So I am discussing these things. In this higher level, you should know all these P and P's and Q's of this Cramer's rule. For example, this problem, for what values of P and Q, the system of equation, 2x plus py plus 6z, x plus equal to 8, x plus 2y plus qz equal to 5, x plus y plus 3z equal to 4. This is a homogeneous equation, inhomogeneous equation, with PQ unknown. So what is the value of PQ? For this equation has, first of all, unique solution, case 2 no solution, case 3 infinite solution. Okay. What is the unique solution? What you know unique solution? Again tell me. Unique solution is del x, del not equal to?
0.
0.
Yes. Del not equal to 0 will give you unique solution. So first of all, you check it. So what is del? The coefficient of the coefficient matrix. What is the coefficient matrix? 2p6, 1, 2q and 1, 1, 3. 2p6, 1, 2q, 1, 1, 3. Make the determinant, that will give you this thing, okay? Just by, I'm making this 0, 0 by subtracting this one. C2, second column, we have subtracted C1 from C2, so P minus 2, 2 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, and C3 minus C3 into 3 minus C1. So, it's got 3, multiply 3 with the first column and subtract with 3 column. So, 6 minus 6, 0, 3 into 1, 1, Q minus 3, and 3 into 1, 3, 3 minus 3, 0. Okay, so I've got maximum number of 0. Now, if you expand this determinant, only this 1 corresponding to 1, there will be this value. P minus 2 into Q minus 2 minus 0. All other will be 0. So this will be P minus Q 2 into Q minus 3. P minus 2 into Q minus 3. Okay. Now, so when the del not equal to 0, tell me. When P not equal to 2, at the same time, Q not equal to 3. In that case, only del not equal to 0. So for any unique solution situation, any unique solution, for existence of unique solution, we must have P not equal to 2, Q not equal to 3. Getting?
Yes, sir.
Is that okay to all? Because for unique solution, del must be not equal to 0, the coefficient matrix. So it is not equal to 0 for these two conditions? Okay. Now, Now, for we are investigating the second situation and third situation. No solution, infinite number. What is no solution case? So in both cases, del must be equal to zero. Okay. If del equal to zero, then if at least one of del x, del y, del z is not equal to zero, then no solution. If all are del x, del y, del z also zero, then infinite solution. So we will investigate this thing now. So first of all, when p equal to 2 or q equal to 3, then del equal to 0. Then this system cannot have a unique solution. Now the case 2, when p equal to 2, then del will be equal to 0. Now let us investigate this del x, del y, and del z for p equal to 2 situation. So del x equal to, just you replace this x column with this inhomogeneous part and putting p is equal to 2. Putting p is equal to 2 and inhomogeneous part is 8, 5, 4. 8, 5, 4, you substitute. That will give you this thing equal to 0. Okay, so del x equal to 0. Okay, del x equal to 0. And del y equal to 0 and del z equal to also 0. Del z is equal to 0. Okay, when p equal to 2. When p equal to 2, you are calculating del x, del y, del z, all of them. Simply calculate from this coefficient matrix, put p is equal to 2. So that will give you del x, del y, z equal to 0. That means infinite solution will exist. When p equal to 0, del equal to 0, del x, del y, del z is all 0. That means infinite solution. Okay. So the system will have infinite solution. Now take the case of q equal to 3. If q equal to 3, then again put q is equal to 3 here. So that will give you del x equal to this p minus 2 into 3, p minus 2 into 3, del x equal to. Okay, now del x will be 0 only when p equal to 2. So if p not equal to 2, then del x not equal to 0, and the system will have no solution again. Okay, system will not solution again, because p not equal to 2 means this del x, okay, I have taken q equal to 3, but p not equal to 0, that is del equal to 0, but this del x is going to be not equal to 0, then system is inconsistent, unsolvable, okay, by this condition 2, okay. Del equal to 0, but at least one of these del x, zero, del z not equal to 0, system will have no solution. Okay. So these are the different situations. So we are summing up. When the system will have del not equal to 0, that is p not equal to 2, q not equal to 3, then it will have a unique solution. It will have no solution if p not equal to 2 and q not equal to 3. Q equal to 3, but p not equal to 3. Unique solution. There is no solution. An infinite solution if p equal to 2. Q can be anything, p equal to 2. Any question? Okay. Next, we will discuss, suppose a determinant is having the cell values as a function of x. So upon expansion, it will give a total function of x. Okay. Suppose the cell values are ux, vx, wx, px, qx, rx, and lambda x, mu x, nu x. These are the cell values. Now, so this is basically a function of x. So if a function of x is given, it should be differentiated. If the function is continuous in a given domain of x. Now, what is the rule for derivative of a determinant? The rule is interesting. The rule is that you differentiate each row at the same time, at one time, okay? So, and you will get three determinants. In the first determinant, you will differentiate only the first row. So, del u del x, del u del v del x, del omega del x, okay? In the second determinant, you will have differentiated this second row, del p del x, del q del x, del r del x, and third equation, del lambda del x, del mu del x, del v del x. Okay, so each row, the same thing will be for column also. You can differentiate with respect to column, or with respect to derivative, same thing. So whatever can be done for column can be done for row also. So these are the things. So if they are differentiated one row each time, and we'll get three determinant for a 3x3 system. So that will be the derivative of a determinant. Okay. Okay, adjoint, this rule is very important. Let A be a square matrix, the transpose of the matrix is corresponding cofactor of the elements of determinant of A is called the adjoint of matrix of A, written as adjoint of A, like this. Every A1 will be substituted with capital A1. What is capital A1? This is nothing but B2, C2, B3, C3. This cofactor submatrix with order 2, that is n minus 1, with minus 1 whole to the power I plus j, that is 1 plus 1, you already know. So this is the substituting this A1 with capital A1, B1 with capital A2 this way, I get a adjoint of A. Actually, not B1, A1 by capital A1, A2 by capital A2, and then I'm taking a transpose, you know. Finally, I have to take a transpose. So that is the adjoint of A. Now, remember that this theorem is not, your proof is not in your syllabus, that result should be applied in some different problems. So adjoint of A, that is equal to the determinant of adjoint of A. The determinant of adjoint of A, that will be equal to determinant of A whole to the power n minus 1. Determinant of A whole to the power n minus 1. Okay. Determinant of adjoint of A is equal to mod A. The mod A means determinant of A whole to the power n minus 1. This is called Jacobi's theorem. This is called Jacobi's theorem. Okay. So when that will be existing, when this determinant not equal to 0. Okay. And there are some more basic rules of algebra. A inverse is equal to A inverse A equal to I. AB inverse equal to B inverse A inverse, provided both are existing. As this you already know, A transpose of transpose equal to A. A plus B transpose equal to A transpose B transpose. And AB transpose equal to B transpose A transpose. And determinant of the square of the square matrix, determinant of the square of the square matrix is equal to square of the determinant of the matrix. That means mod of A square equal to mod A whole square. Okay. It is true in general also. Mod of A to the power n equal to mod A whole to the power n. And this is another very important relation. Adjoint of A, that is equal to A to the power n minus 2 into A. So if you take determinant of both sides, it can be at once shown that this Jacobi's rule can be shown. This can be shown. How this can be shown? Please note that. This adjoint of A is equal to mod A whole to the power n minus 2 into A. So if you take determinant both sides, this is determinant of adjoint of A, that is determinant of this thing, determinant of A of n minus 2, determinant of A. Okay. And determinant of A of n minus 2, this A of n minus 2 will be coming outside. So determinant of A is going to again mod A, that will be mod A whole to the power n minus 1. Mod A whole to the power n minus 1. Okay. And these results are not much important for you. Generalized results are some results are given. Forget about the results. And now, this is again in your syllabus. Solve the following equations by matrix inversion method. Solve the following, that is just by matrix, by using inverse matrix. So what you know, the solution method is very simple. If you are given a system, Ax equal to D. Okay, D is the inhomogeneous factor, that is this 0, 10, 5. X is equal to the solution vector, x, y, z. And capital A is the coefficient, the determined by the coefficients, square matrix of the coefficients, that is 2, 1, 2, 2 minus 1, 1, 1, 3, minus 1. Okay, these are the coefficient matrix. So this is a vector form or matrix form of the system. A x equal to d. A x equal to d. X is the x, y, z solution vector. And 0, 10, 5 is the inhomogeneous part d. Then if you multiply from the left hand side, if you multiply with from left hand side, if you multiply with A inverse, please note, this is given. Okay, if you multiply from left hand side A inverse, why it is important to mention left hand side or right hand side? Can you say why it is important to mention left hand side or right hand side? Because the matrix multiplication is not always commutative. Okay, so I multiply with left hand side and then applying one parenthesis rule, that is associativity. Applying associativity, so A inverse AX, that will become A inverse A into X. What is A inverse A? That is I into X is X. I into X is X. And in the right hand side, what will be that? A inverse D. A inverse D. So X will be equal to A inverse D. So what is the power of, what is the order of D? 3 by 1. 3 row, 1 column. 3 by 1. What is the order of A inverse? That is also A. That is 3 by 3. So the A inverse D, the after multiplication, this will have a determinant of, I have a matrix of 3 by 1. 3 into 3, 3 into 1. That is 3 by 1. 3 by 1 is a column vector. Okay. And that values will correspond to the values of X, Y, Z. See what is being done. Now, A inverse equal to, we already know, adjoint of A by mod A, determinant of A. Okay. That will give you adjoint of A is again 3 by 3 matrix. And dividing by mod A, that will not change the order. That will actually, again, a 3 by 3 matrix. And mod A, the value of mod A is equal to 13. So adjoint of A will be finally this minus 2, 7, 3 and 3 minus all these things. A inverse will be 1 by 13, that is 1 by mod A into adjoint of A, you already know. And that is equal to this thing. Okay, 1 by 13 into minus 2, 7, 3, 3 minus 4, 2, 7 minus 4. Okay, and into, this is equal to A inverse and A inverse D. What is D? 0, 10, 5. So A inverse D will be 3 into 3 and 3 into 1. That is 3 into 1. This is a 3 into 1 matrix. Okay. 3 into 1 matrix. What is that? 85 by 13 minus 30 by 30 and 70 by 13. This is basically equal to X. What is X? X, Y, Z. X equal to this X, Y, Z. So corresponding value will be matched. X equal to 85 by 13. Y is equal to minus 30 by 13. Z is equal to minus 70 by 13. This method is also very much familiar to all of you. You have done it in your event 12 and 19 event. And what is the limitation of this method? When A inverse does not exist. So one thing should be very clear to all of you. When the Cramer's rule will fail, that is determinant of A equal to 0, then also the matrix method will also fail. Okay. Matrix method will also fail.
Sir, Cramer's rule will apply only on the matrix which is greater than 3 by 3 matrices, not on 2 by 2 matrix. Can we apply on that?
No, at 2 by 2 also. No problem. You have to find del x and del y and del z and del. So,
yes,
2 by 2 ke liye karne ke kya problem kya hai? Sabhi to kar sakte ho. Tum beta bhi nikal sakte ho, koi bhi determinant and all this matrix bhi nikal sakte ho, del x, del y, del z. It can be applied to any order, but if you apply it for order greater than 3, the thing will be very much computation oriented, greater than equal to 3, I'm bold, right? 4 by 4, so much that uska determinant nikalne ke liye tumko kya karna padega, bahut sara calculation karna padega.
Yes sir,
uske liye hamare liye aur ek easier method hai, usko kehte hai Gaussian elimination method. Gauss elimination method we will learn later. Next day we will learn Gauss elimination method. For larger matrix, the Gauss elimination method is most useful. Very easily and at once it can be found. Okay. Because for 4 by 2 and 5 by 5, you can understand how to find the adjoint matrix, to find the determinant, everything will be very long computation, cumbersome. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Or anyone else is having any doubt? Okay. So I will not discuss any more for this. I will not start this Gauss elimination other topics. Let me go through the syllabus again. Then I will again prepare the notes for the next class. So for today, I'm completing here. Everyone give your attendance and leave. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Bye.
Bye, sir.
अभी ज्यादा सिलेबस बाकी नहीं है, धीरे धीरे चलो, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, पूरा आसानी से खत्म हो जाएगा, ज्यादा हड़बड़ करने का कोई जरूरत नहीं है, ठीक है?
ओके सर, थैंक यू सर,
सब ये कर दो, अटेंडेंस दे दो बस।
ओके
सर, टेस्ट कॉपीज आर चेक्ड सर,
टेस्ट कॉपीज आर चेक्ड, नंबर हैज आल्सो सेंट, बट सम ऑफ यू हैज नॉट, वी हैव गिवन सम प्रॉब्लम कर दिया, वो हमको पीडीएफ भेजा, उसको देखने में थोड़ा टाइम लगेगा, देख सकता, तुम्हारा पीडीएफ पढ़ा ही नहीं जाता, एक एक पीडीएफ भेजा उसको तो पूरा एकदम कलर्ड हो गया, उसमें कुछ दिखाई नहीं जाता, हम पढ़ नहीं सकते।
सर मार्क्स कब तक बताएंगे सर?
मार्क्स तो बस ज्यादा से ज्यादा लड़का का दे दिया मार्क्स, डिपार्टमेंट में दे दिया।
सर हम लोग को कब पता चलेगा सर?
तुमको पता है डिपार्टमेंट से देगा तो तुम डिपार्टमेंट से थोड़ा बताओ उसको बताने के लिए, क्योंकि
स्टूडेंट सब्जेक्ट टीचर बताएंगे ना?
नहीं नहीं नहीं, स्टूडेंट्स ये सब्जेक्ट बताएंगे, लेकिन स्टूडेंट्स ग्रुप में देना थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम होगा, तो हर कोई हमको पूछेगा ये सर वो सर क्या हुआ सर, इतना तो हमारा लिए संभव नहीं है हर कोई को ये करना, तो हम डिपार्टमेंट बताए, तुम डिपार्टमेंट से खबर लो, थोड़ा हेड से तुम्हारा जो मेंटर है मास उसके पास होना चाहिए, ठीक है? अभी उसके बाद किस कोई कुछ का कोई बताना है तो बोल सकते हो हमको, ठीक है? और कुछ कुछ मार्क्स नहीं गया, फॉर एग्जांपल वो जो उसका सीएस का है और आईटी का, भूल भी गया, साक्षी बर्मन है, वो बता रहा था कल, वो भेजा नहीं पीडीएफ ठीक से, ये सब थोड़ा बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, उसको हम देख के ठीक करना पड़ेगा, लेकिन लगभग 80% का मार्क्स तो हम भेज दिया करके, ठीक है? तो देख लो
फिजिक्स में तो मैम क्लास में ही दिखा दी मार्क्स,
मार्क्स नहीं दिखे थे, अगर तुम बोलते हो तो हम ग्रुप में भेज सकते हो, लेकिन ठीक है हम ग्रुप में एक बार भेजते हैं, देखते हैं क्या करते हैं, ग्रुप में भी भेज दूंगा, ठीक है? हम एक बार हेड से बात करते हैं, उसके बाद अगर वो बोलते हैं कि तुम्हारा ग्रुप में मार्क्स दे दे तो हम दे देंगे, ठीक है?
ओके सर,
ओके सर,
ओके ओके ओके,
थैंक यू सर,
ठीक ठीक,
थैंक यू सर,
ओके बाय।
बाय सर।